All new at 6, Bay Area hospitals report a rise in COVID-19 patients. We're following up with doctors for a second day in a row and getting new information about the impact this recent surge is having on children. Good evening and thank you for joining us. I'm Wendy Ryan.
And I'm Jameson Euler. ABC Action News reporter Mary O'Connell is following this closely for us. Tonight she has the message straight from doctors to all of you at home.
As communities across the country see a spike in COVID-19 cases, hospitals in the Tampa Bay area continue to deal with the surge, including at Johns Hopkins All Children's.
From a pediatric standpoint, we have not seen this. This is the worst that we've had since the pandemic started by far.
I spoke to Dr. Joseph Perno, Johns Hopkins All Children's chief medical officer, about what they're seeing with COVID-19 cases. He tells me for their pediatric patients, they're seeing a continued rise.
We've seen over the last 7 days double the number of positives that we saw the previous 7 days. Fortunately, most of these children are being seen in our emergency room and sent home. We haven't seen a dramatic change in hospitalization rates.
I checked in with other local hospitals too. At Sarasota Memorial, they tell me their COVID inpatient census, which was in the single digits earlier this month, is now 92, saying it has doubled since last week. BayCare says it's curtailing some elective procedures in its hospitals in Hillsborough and Polk counties due to a growing census in its hospitals. Adding in the past 3 weeks, COVID patients in BayCare hospitals have increased more than threefold. Many health experts point to the Delta variant and relaxed masking as factors behind it all. The rapid rise in cases also taking a toll on healthcare workers.
Our nursing staff, our physician staff, they're stretched and they're tapped. You know, we're seeing wintertime volumes at a time that it should be a lull for us.
According to a statewide COVID-19 update from the Florida Hospital Association, current hospitalizations as of today are at about 8,800, while on a previous peak on July 23rd last year, there were just over 10,000. At All Children's, Dr. Perno explained they're fortunate that most of the children don't require hospitalization, so they're requiring limited resources, but says they have surge plans in place if needed to help protect the most vulnerable, especially those who aren't eligible for the COVID-19 vaccine. Doctors urge you to wear a mask and get vaccinated.
Anytime we are faced with any disease that I can't just fix easy, right? Write a prescription for an antibiotic and say, get better. It makes us feel as healthcare workers very frustrated, very helpless. And this is one of those diseases.
Mary O'Connell, ABC Action News.